Hi there, nice that you're watching. Today it's December 4th, 2023 in Amsterdam. I'm Tycho from Amsterdam, born and raised in Amsterdam, and I'm cycling through Amsterdam, as you can see. These are some highlights of the route I'm doing today here in Amsterdam. Amsterdam, Amsterdam, Amsterdam. You take a shot every time I say Amsterdam and you'll turn out, really drunk. So yeah, these are still some highlights. I'm cycling to my parents' house. And I thought let's just put some highlights here. I sometimes do that in the beginning of the video, because for you as a viewer, you see like, okay, yeah, you know, something is actually gonna happen. Some, you know, a dog almost in front of me. What else here? The flower market. Anyways, it was a very cold day today. I'm wearing gloves, a hat, a scarf. And yeah, everyone is doing so, as you can see. But you know, in some countries there's a big pile of snow already, and here we're very fortunate that there's no snow yet. So here, this is the start of the video. Leidse Canal, or Leidse Gracht in Dutch. So here on the right, this is gonna be a new 5-star hotel. They're working on it already for over 2 years, and it's gonna be huge. So it's at the Prins Canal and also in the Lange Leidse Dwarsstraat. In Dutch, the long light side street. And it's gonna be a huge hotel. First, their plan was to mainly focus on the rich Russian and Chinese people, but now because of the war, I think they skipped that first part. So let's just focus on the rich Chinese, or I don't know, people who are interested in staying in those 5-star hotels in the middle of Amsterdam. And one of my best friends is living right in front of that hotel. So yeah, I'm witnessing, you know, the progress of this hotel gradually. I see it, I don't see anything still, but yeah, they're working hard. So I decided for to go a little bit through the city of Amsterdam in the center. It's actually going in the opposite direction of my parents' house where I'm going. So, but I thought, yeah, you know, some nice shots here in the center. It's winter. And actually it is winter now, right? Because you have the meteorological winter and the other winter. And one of the first, or I don't know, one of the two starts at December 1st and the other one starts at December 22nd. So yeah, for some people it is winter now. And actually here in the Netherlands we say the winter starts at December 22nd or something, but it already feels pretty much like winter here in the 9th streets. Let's go on the trottoir, pedestrian road for a second, because this truck is, you know, stopping for this car, and I decided, yeah, I'm not gonna wait. And here I slowly go down, otherwise, yeah, my wheel will get a bump. I mean, not a bump, but a dent. And yeah, we don't want that, because those wheels are like 50, 60 euro each. And with we, I mean me. So I take care of my bikes. So one thing you should never do is ride off the pedestrian road. Here's the dog. Oh, and she's pulling him so hard. Poor little doggy. Oh, by the way, look. So in front of us, this tiny little street upcoming. In one of my most viewed TikToks, I was able to ride through it. But now you see the pedestrian road, it continues. We, as a cyclist, we are not able to go in that street anymore. I will put it now here on the screen, here on the right. So here you see, I was going through this street last year in 2022. And yeah, so they renovated it. I guess it's better for the pedestrians, because as you can see in this TikTok video, it was pretty crowded. But while I was, just now, while I was looking back at these shots, like an hour ago, I saw like, hey, wait a second, wasn't I cycling through that street? So yeah, now they're just, I don't know, made a little bit better for the pedestrian road. I, as a cyclist, I thought it was quite fun, you know, to cycle through that street full of tourists, and they'll be like, oh no, cyclist is coming. But yeah, that's in the past. At least I'm glad I made those shots last year. So yeah, this looks nice. Here on the right is that beautiful floating flower market I'm always talking about. And yeah, so this is at the end of the Singelkanaal. In front of us is the Mint Tower. By the way, I made a video about the single canal, like, in the first year of me doing YouTube, in the first few months. It was pretty good video. Actually, if I look back at it now, I would do it differently, but yeah, you know, pretty good. I explained a lot about the single. And at this point, I decided, so, okay, I thought I'm gonna go to the right, but I decided now, like, you know what, I'm gonna go straight ahead and not go through the Ferdinand Bol Street to my parents' house. Just, you know, a little bit different. What else can I say? So anyways, thank you for watching. Last video I was narrating, I was cycling with two bikes, and yeah, unfortunately the second bike was not really in the screen, so I guess maybe once I'll try to do it again, and then maybe with two cameras or something like that. But I read a lot of nice comments on that video, so yeah, some appreciation. Oh look, and that girl, but yeah, I showed, I'm gonna go to the right. Oppa. She didn't see me point my finger. Well, I tried. So coming up is Rembrandt Square. There's a statue of Rembrandt, which we're not able to see. There's an ice skating thing going on. Here on the left, you can buy oliebollen, or in English, oil balls. That's what we Dutch people eat when it's Christmas, aka, and also not aka, and also New Year's Eve. Sorry, there's a lot of thoughts in my mind. I see these shots, but I also doesn't look. Rembrandt on the left. Yes, the statue. So yeah, Rembrandt Square is one of the main squares in Amsterdam. I always say there's like three main squares, yeah, which is Dam Square, Rembrandt Square, and, well, what's the third one, ladies and gentlemen? Leidse Square. So. And here we're going through the Utrecht Street. Actually, I'm not allowed to cycle here, this little part, but yeah. It's just this tiny, you see there's a tram line, and I thought, yeah, I just have to go to that, yeah, to this point right here. So from now it's okay again. What was I saying? Yeah, I don't know. Concerto music store somewhere here. Maybe I passed it already. Yeah, so the Utrechtse Straat, the Utrechtse Straat. I'm not that familiar with it myself. People are really fond of it. Okay, look here, this Tesla is stopping. Then you got this cyclist who was like, okay, I was at this point like, hello, why don't you just continue? But she was maybe a bit afraid for the Tesla, I understand. Elon. Oh, here's the Concerto store. Yeah, on the right. And that was it. So one of the, if you like collecting records, etc., that's where you send people, that's where you, where I send the people, go to Concerto. Among other stores, I'd say Concerto is one of the places definitely to check out if you like collecting their records. Just, yeah, music, CDs in general. Yeah. Yeah, because my parents, they live in Buitenveldert, so it's a bit, yeah, it's a totally different area of Amsterdam. And I decided, yeah, let's cycle a tiny bit through the center. So first I was cycling in the opposite direction here. Okay, the light is gonna turn green now. And I'm quickly going in front. It's, yeah, a little bit egoistic maybe, I'm sorry. But you know, it's a taxi. Look, he will come on the left now. It's a cab driver, so we don't have to feel sorry for him. I mean, they're always very egoistic themselves, so if I cut him off a little bit, it won't hurt anyone. Maybe it will hurt myself if he'll hit me or something. Anyways, so Buitenveldert is a very calm and peaceful area, and I guess most of the viewers watching a video about Buitenveldert will probably click away, because it will not look like typical Amsterdam. So that's why I decided, you know, first a little bit through the center to start it off. And now at this point, if you're still here, you're one of the, yeah, the few who didn't click off, huh? Because the further I will cycle in this video, the more it will look like, the least the less it will look like Amsterdam, not the more, the less. Yeah. But it's actually nice nowadays. They try to make new areas in Amsterdam still, and in the old style. So in the 90s there was this wall, and let's try to do different stuff, you know, make very ugly buildings or something. It's really, I don't know what's in their up in their minds, the architects from the 90s. But nowadays they're making, you know, very nice new neighborhoods. So, you know what, maybe next week or something I'll cycle through one of those neighborhoods. Maybe I did actually also, like 2 years ago or something. But let me do it next week again. And then you see, like, it's brand new, but in the old style. Yeah, I'm going to the left. All right, very good, Tycho. Very good. Just a little bit through the pipe area. By the way, don't forget to hit that like button down here. It will really help me out, the algorithm. And if you feel like it, you can donate a coffee in my in the description. And the coffee goes towards me, so good cause. This is the Albert Cuyp Market. Well, actually, I crossed it. The most famous market of the country, but you didn't see anything of it now. And actually, yeah, with this weather, there were not a lot of people. There was no. Actually, it was. Maybe the market was closed. I didn't pay attention. So, yeah, pretty cold. Safari Park coming up. Named after Samuel Sarfati. I'll once make a video about this as well. In my top 10 bridges, the number 9 bridge of Amsterdam is right here in this park. The Love Bridge. That's the name of the bridge. Look at this cyclist with those buckets, like one in front and then also one in the back. It's pretty cool. I think it will be pretty hard to cycle with the one in the back especially. So yeah, these days there's much less people in Amsterdam. Yeah, I really notice it, like hotels are empty, streets are empty. I mean, look at this. There's almost no people on the streets. Even in the center just now. He's taking off his jacket. Ice cold, but yeah. You don't want your jacket to wrinkle in the car. I understand, monsieur. I understand. Yeah, a little bit zigzagging through the pipe area. It's nice, you know. Instead of taking the two big roads. Yeah. Look at the street. Coming up at Hendrik de Keizer Square, which is it's a huge square. I used to play there as well as a kid sometimes, because I was living here in this area. I had a pipe. So here on the left, it's huge. On the camera, it looks okay, but it's huge. Seriously, huge playground. And I guess there's multiple schools actually in this area. And look at the architecture here on the left. Yeah, so the Amsterdamse school style, or Amsterdam school style. So that architecture style, it has a lot of bricks and a lot of little windows. And then you got those round shapes on the building. Maybe there will be another one coming up. I don't think so. But you know, actually I should make a video about this architecture style. I guess it will do bad, but yeah, it's quite interesting. There's a beautiful building. Actually, I'll link it down below. I made a video about Zaanhof, one of the hidden gems, little courtyards in Amsterdam, Zaanhof Courtyard. And there's a very, very, very nice building in front of Zaanhof, so actually right out of Zaanhof, which is like the number one Amsterdam school style building in Amsterdam. And it's beautiful, really. It's a museum now, also the ship, so you can go in it. But the most nice thing about this museum is its outside, the outside, you know, the building itself. I mean, what's inside the building is very, very boring. Of course, that's my opinion. But, let's just say that 99% of you will agree with me. But the building itself, it's beautiful. So here's a photo, by the way, of the building on the screen. But there's lots of these buildings in this style, the Amsterdam school style, right here in the pipe area. So yeah, not in this video, unfortunately. It's a little bit more to the left, in the Diamantenbuurt, or Diamond Neighborhood. Yeah, so we're flowing from the pipe area now into the Rivierenbuurt, a river neighborhood, for a little while. And then we're in Buitenvelders, and then that's it already. So yeah, goes pretty cool. Here I was thinking like, hello, where are you going? To this dude. He didn't go to the left. Yeah. It's funny, when I see these videos back, the thoughts I had at the moment when I was cycling returned to my mind again. But I'll not speak, I'll not tell them all these thoughts, because I'd be talking endlessly. Maybe it already feels like I'm talking endlessly, but really, there's a lot of thoughts. See again, oil balls here on the left. It's that time of the year again. It's the season. What's it called? It's the most wonderful season. Blah blah blah. The song. It's the happiest season of all. Holy ball here and there, la 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 la. Yeah, but here in the Netherlands, by the way, I mean, you see a lot of Christmas lights here and there, but actually tomorrow, or yeah, whenever you're watching this, but on the 5th of December, it's Sinterklaas, yeah, or Saint Nicholas. It's another dude, so not Santa Claus, who actually derived from St. Nicholas and the stories. But here in the Netherlands, we're still celebrating St. Nicholas. So, yeah, that's on December 5th. But yeah, Christmas is so nice and fun, and everyone enjoys it. So those lights are just, you know, some people already hang it up in October. Oh yeah, here another one of my friends is living in this big street. Well, not living, but yeah, quote unquote living. And maybe if you got some, you know, certain areas you want to see, you know, you want to see me cycle through, like, hey Tycho, why don't you cycle through this and that street? You can let me know down in the comments below. Maybe you got some ideas, like I should put something in my basket, eh? Of course it would be fun, a dog or a cat, but you know, something realistic, eh, for now. I mean, dogs and cats are realistic, yes. I just don't know people with dogs. Like, I mean, I know a person with two dogs, but they're too fragile. So if you have a dog, I was avoiding the water over there. Yeah. If you have a dog and you're here in Amsterdam and, you know, you feel like, hey, Tycho, why don't you go for a ride with my dog? Then I'll be happy to. If it's a nice dog. think this is the swimming pool, but not sure. There's a swimming pool here, or maybe not. Het de Miranda Bad. It's like de was his first name. The. Very confusing. So in Dutch, the, but then two different deaths. I'm gonna explain it right now. I am allowed to cycle here. There was a sign, cyclist allowed or something. And yeah, this is all brand new. This piece of grass here on the left, well, in 2 years it will be gone for sure. It feels like 2 years ago none of these buildings were here. It was just all grass. And now look at it. It's like the extension of the Zuidas area, the business district, but this is like, this is not the business district, but it's the extension of it. And then, yeah, that creative building up there on the right, well, that is a business building, so. But these buildings here, I think they're just apartments. But you see, it's not finished yet. Oh, it's also a hotel or something, this, by the way. I don't know. And look at that other hotel over there with the three triangles on top of each other. Very nice. Coming up is a train station / metro station, etc. Station Rai, Amsterdam Rai. R-A-I. And here in the south, there's also the Rai Convention Center with huge conventions like the IBC. Maybe some of you will know. Some computer exhibition. Here you see Amsterdam Rai written over there. And this station, it has a lot of travelers, but it looks so shabby still. So I think, I mean, it will always stay small, but they can make it a little bit, I don't know, nicer, a bit more modern. Yeah, money, yeah. Let's just first focus on the business district and then... Yeah, they're doing Station South now, by the way, the next station. And then maybe when that is finished in 10, 20 years, then they'll do this station or something, I guess. Oh yeah, and this is the end of the video, I see. I'm gonna put my thumbs up now, for those of you who forgot to press thumbs up. And yes, you can see this is Buitenveldert, right here. So I thought, you know what, let's just stop the video here. I'm waving bye-bye. Press that like button, woo, you, push like, and I see you in the next video. Thank you for listening, and take care. Happy Sinterklaas tomorrow.